Hello everyone, this is Komal. We were discussing the weather and climate part for class 7, and this is the second part video for this topic. Now we are going to discuss the weather instruments. We already discussed weather and climate and elements of weather. Now we will discuss how we can measure weather phenomena. So here is the topic, weather instruments. Weather instruments are used to measure various elements of weather. So according to that, they have given they are categorizing the weather phenomena, how we can calculate or measure the weather conditions. First one is measuring, how we can measure temperature. To measure temperature, we are simply using thermometer. Thermometer is the measuring instrument for the temperature. The thermometer measures temperature in Fahrenheit or in Celsius form, and another scale is called the Kelvin. Fahrenheit is used mainly in the United States, and this Celsius used more common in the rest of the world. Next thing is temperature also marked with F are recorded for the Fahrenheit scale and C marked for the Celsius. Air temperature at any given place change throughout the day. A special type of thermometer called the 6 maximum and minimum thermometer is used to measure the maximum and minimum temperature throughout the year. This is a special kind of instrument we are using to measuring the temperature of particular place, maximum and minimum temperature. Then measuring humidity. How we can measure humidity? It can be measured through the measuring unit grams per cubic meter, and for this we are using the instrument hygrometer. Hygrometer is instrument used for measuring relative humidity. It measures the water vapor in atmosphere. For hygrometer picture, it is given on page number 30. You can see it from here. Now the next thing is air pressure. How we can measure air pressure? It is a lightweight atmospheric pressure, and the weight exert pressure on the surface of earth. Atmospheric pressure is the pressure exerted on the unit area on the earth surface by gases present in air. A barometer is the instrument that we are using to measure air pressure. So barometer, the picture of barometer is also given on your book, page number 31. You can see it from here. Barometer instrument used to measure atmospheric pressure, and it is also called the mercury barometer. It provides the pressure of air, which can be read on the scale marked on the glass tube. And atmospheric pressure is measured in millibars, and 1013 millibars is considered to be the normal atmospheric pressure. So in mercury barometer, when it was not in easily accessible, then aneroid barometer was used. Now the next thing is measuring rainfall. How we can measure rainfall? Rainfall can be measured through instrument rain gauge. It is a simple long glass cube. Through that we are measuring rain. It is the meteorologist measure rainfall using an instrument called the rain gauge, and this measurement is that of the depth of water that would occur if the rain did not drain away. In a rain gauge, rain pours in through a funnel into a container, and after every 24 hours the water so collected in container is poured into a measuring cylinder that gives a reading of the day's total rainfall. Our rain gauge must always be placed on open with no hindrance or any kind of obstacle where there will not be there. At that place we are placing this rain gauge and afterward we are collecting rain droplets in it. After 24 hours we are measuring the amount of rainwater in it, like trees, hindrance like trees, wall around air and the level land to collect and measure the rainfall correctly. Now observing wind speed and direction. To observe wind speed and direction, we are using wind vane. For this purpose, we are using the simple instrument wind vane. Wind vane. If you know about the direction in which the wind is blowing, we can use a simple simple instrument called wind vane, and it comprises a rotating arm pivoted on the vertical rod. An arrow is fixed on the rod pointing in the direction from which the wind is blowing, and afterward we are getting the main direction where it is. Now the next thing is anemometer. It is the instrument helps to measure the speed of the wind. To measure speed of wind, this is for the wind vane for the direction, and for wind speed we are using anemometer. Anemometer picture is also given on the on your book, page number 32. You can see it from here. This is a simple instrument we are using when we are measuring the wind speed. The speed of the wind is measured in kilometers per hour or the meters per second. When the numbers on the of the rotations of the cup is more, it indicates that the wind is blowing at a high speed. So next is Beaufort scale, that is based on the effect of wind at a different speed, is used to estimate the speed of the wind. Next is isohyoids or isotherms. Isohyoids are the line which is used to connect the areas on the map which receive the same amount of rainfall. Next is isotherms, the lines, the joining places on the map which experiences same temperature or the equal temperature. It is connecting places on the map which are having the same amount of rainfall. An isotherm, connecting places on the map surface which are having same amount of or the equal temperature. So here is our topic. If you will get any query, you can ask me through comment section. Thank you so much. I hope you understood.